Welcome to part three, finally, of my little lesson on playing some Delta Blues guitar. Now, I've been getting all kinds of messages about this. I'm really sorry, I've been really busy. A lot of things have been happening. I've been touring, playing solo shows around the place. And with my real teaching, obviously, I don't get a hell of a lot of time. So let's have a look at this. Let's see if we can get this to work. So let's just revise. First of all, I'll just go back and play you the whole piece that we've been working on, and then we'll get on with the next bit, which is the last bit, part three. Thanks for hanging in there, guys. Here, guys, is essentially in the same position as you start the song, so 12th fret, 10th fret, and we're just going to play them as a, so that first bar, 1 and 2 and 3 and then we're going to play 4, okay, so we put our pinky up on the 12th fret, 4 and so E string with your pinky, E string back on the 10th fret, B string, 4 and so we're going to obviously bass on the quarter notes like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and okay, do that again. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and okay, there's your first bar. Second bar, we're going to play 7 and 8. A little bend on the B string. So, 1 and So literally go 1 and is open B and E strings. So, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2, play the A shape and play the B and G strings while you play the E note. 2. So, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and Now on the you're going to keep holding the A chord and just play on the E, on the D string, that's the E note. So 2 and okay, then on 3 we're going to go back to this E shape and we're going to hammer on the G string to a G sharp on the first fret, and go three at the same time as we play the bass note. Three and four. Okay? So those two bars go like this. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. Cool. Next two bars, some stuff that I've really probably pinched off Robert Lockwood, but hey, he played with Robert Johnson. So starting here, back at the start, 12th and 10th. We're going to go 1 and a, 2 and a. Okay, the next thing's a little bit different because we're actually essentially playing an A-shaped, bottom half of an A-shaped E here. So 1 and a. Now on the and, you just play open B and E. 1 and a, 2 and a, 3 and a. Then down a whole step, 4 and a. Okay, one and a. Now that's the last time you're going to play those open strings. So it's one and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, two. Just slip it down a semitone. Okay, so it's one and a, two and a, three and a, four. Now the whole time you're just playing quarter notes on the bass, so one and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, two and a, three and a, four. All right, let's do that whole thing, that whole first four bars. One and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, two and a, three and a, four. So the A section, guys, is so the only difference there is we're adding that trill, right? And a, one and a, two and a, three and a, four. The one and a, two. Now here is where it kind of doubles around. One and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one. And we go all the way up to that high instead of going like we did in the second chorus. It's up to the high E. So, one and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, two and a, three and a, four. So again, a B7 chord. One and a, two and a. On the and a is the E and the G. Then three on the third fret with your pinky. Three and a, open B, four. One and a, two and a, three and a, four and a. One and a, two and a, three and a, four and a. Okay, so one and a, two and a. So that's the bottom of an A7 chord essentially. One and a, two and a, E, B string. And a, two and a, three and a. So seven, six, five. One and a, two and a, three and a, four and... Nice bend, Darren. Don't go that far. Semitone. Three and a, four and a, one and a, two and a, three and a, etc. So you know the rest of that turnaround. Now the ending of the song is essentially the same as the beginning. The only thing that's different is it's got a little tag on the end to end it. So you play all the same stuff you play all the same stuff you play in the first time through, except at the end you go... And I kind of straighten up the feel, so it's... rather than... So it's like... And here's the rundown. 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 2. Sorry, when I say one there, I mean open. 3, 2, open, 3, 2, open, 2, 1. Then you use that. Remember? But this time around, we're just doing it without any bass. And it's just... It's a, basically an E chord, then an E6 chord, and an E7 chord. And that's the end. So it's 1 and up, 1 and up, 2, 1 and up, 2 and up, 3 and up, 4 and up, 1 and up, 2 and up, 3 and up, 4 and up, 1 and up, 2 and up, 3 and up, 4 and up, 1 and up, 2 and up, and then hit the E chord at the end. And that, folks, is the whole piece. I'm going to be working very, very soon on some slide guitar for you all, and hopefully some more pieces that we can work on just with raw fingerstyle. Thanks for sticking with us. More to come. Peace. Here's to the end of the plutocracy, for those of you who know what that means. And that's the only political thing I'm ever going to say. So good luck to you. Please send me feedback, drop me a line. Doing Skype lessons with some people all over the world at the moment, as well as my regular students. So yeah, drop me an email, info@darrenwatson.com. Thanks for listening, and we'll catch you soon.